So at first it started, hey, Bert Show, can I propose to my girlfriend without an engagement ring? And we debated that a little bit, and now things have gone a little on the sideways side. We got an update today. Dob, you going to take care of this one, or am I reading this one?
Well, I'm going to tell you about yesterday, how he told us, like, yeah, I want to propose to my girlfriend on her birthday on Thursday, but I also got this business venture that I'm going to use all my savings and everything I've been saving up for her ring to use. So there was that added, like, he was like, can I propose without a ring? And also, can I have a business and, like, take this business on without talking to her about her finances and all that other stuff? So there were a lot of layers to this, but I can read the update if you'd like.
I'll read it. At some point yesterday, Cassie, our social media director and EVP, actually, of marketing, who has been promoted, said something to the effect of, actually, some women might think the engagement and the ring is a priority over the actual wedding itself. Did you say that yesterday?
Yeah. If I had to choose, to me, the actual having a ring would be more important than having a wedding, like the party, not the marriage. Like, you would still obviously get married at a courthouse, but the actual physical symbol on my finger would be more important than the big white dress and the party with everybody.
Yeah, and I guess I'll read the update here in just 1 second, because there is one and it's not going great. But I guess what the problem that I'm having attaching myself to this whole thing is that the ring is just the symbol of the action, which is the most important thing of an entire marriage, right? It's the words, it's the acceptance. I'm telling you, I want to be with only you for the rest of my life. So why does that ring hold so much more value than the words or the act itself?
It's part of the package. It's something you can look down at your finger every single day and be like, oh, that's a reminder of the love. It's like, it's unfortunately sort of what's expected in a proposal now. So I'm not saying this is right, but I'm saying if it's missing, you feel a little cheated. Unless you're like completely not materialistic at all, then more power to you. But I would think, like, it feels like something's missing. It would be like, it's like Christmas. Of course, it's like, if you're Christian, it's about the birth of Jesus Christ, and that's why we do it, and it's love with friends and family. But if you don't get gifts and you were expecting gifts, you feel a little cheated. You're like, I got you a gift. You know, what's going on here?
And Davi, I think you were on the other side of the spectrum there yesterday, yes?
I guess a little bit. I was like, you can get like a little like silver ring for like $100, not even $200 to do that. But I think Cassie, are you saying like there has to be a ring or there has to be a diamond?
No, there just has to be a ring. It doesn't matter how expensive the ring is. There just has to be like a thing to put on your finger.
Okay. Some kind of placeholder saying, rent this space.
Yes. Yes. It's like those billboards that don't have like it's just like, you can have this space if you want it, but it's mine. So I kind of agree with Kat. Like Cassie was saying, if you're super low maintenance, you don't care about a ring. That's the person I thought I was. And then my husband proposed with a $30 ring from Dillard's, and I had to walk around with that as a placeholder until we got my real ring, and women kept grabbing my hand, like when I was walking down the hallway at work, and they'd yank my arm and look at it at every angle, and then they'd look at me like, oh honey, like that's fake and plastic, like they were so sad. So then I realized, like, maybe I'm not as low maintenance as I thought. I really, like, I hated this whole period.
So then let me follow up with that. So would you have rather have just had the engagement, the proposal, without the ring than have a cheap ring? Yes.
With that time I was like, I wish you would have proposed and we would have kept it on the download, like top secret, until we got my real ring, because I really hated walking around with that dumb.
Okay. All right. Well, here is your follow-up. Yes, it was her birthday, but I did not propose, is the email that he gave us. I actually didn't even bring it up or explain that I wasn't proposing. I did take her to dinner and I gave her a gift. I could tell her, I could tell she was disappointed when the night was over and no proposal happen. However, I didn't want to even acknowledge or mention it because I wasn't prepared to have the conversation about why I didn't propose. After hearing your thoughts on the entire issue, I decided to do what Cassie suggested. Never do that!
What?
And find an inexpensive stone. I just didn't have time to do that between hearing your advice and this evening. I couldn't remember the name of the stone Cassie suggested, but I did some research and found M-O-I-S-S-A-N-I-T-E. Is that what you were talking about?
I said morganite. Moissanite is also great. It looks exactly like a diamond.
Okay. He says, is that what you said? If so, great, because I found a perfect ring for about $200 on Amazon with Prime. It should be here by Monday, so I plan to propose then. From Adam.
Moissanite's really beautiful. Like, honestly, Google it. Those diamonds, those are stones are stunning, and a lot of women are actually choosing that over diamonds because you can get bigger, flashier rocks with it for way cheaper.
Okay, so will she know immediately that that's not a diamond? And I'm wondering, if not, is there a diamond disappointment when she realizes that this is just the placeholder?
I think he has to tell her. She won't know immediately. She'll just think it's the most beautiful diamond that she's ever seen. He has to tell her because...
Oh, he does.
Yeah, because otherwise, like, it feels like he's passing it off as a diamond. And then I don't know what his plan is. Is he gonna get her, like, a diamond ring? Or she might just be happy with this one, but he's gotta tell her.
Davi.
And usually right after you get an engagement ring, assuming it's like an expensive engagement ring, it's suggested that you go get it like appraised and you add it to your insurance policy and all that kind of stuff. So like he needs to tell her. Otherwise, she's going to go through those steps and do that thing. And she's going to find out from somebody else that it's not a real diamond.
All right. Brandy says y'all are being superficial. Doesn't have anything to do with the price of the ring. Hey, Brandy.
We know, Brandy. We know.
Hey, Brandy.
Hey, how are y'all?
Good. Thank you.
Yeah, my husband, when he asked me to marry him, I got a $10 ring from Walmart in a display, and we went and picked it out together, and it was just $10.
Now, hold on a second. Now, I've heard about going and picking out diamonds together, but I have never heard about going to Walmart and picking out rings from Walmart together. This is what you did?
Got a ring pop.
Yes, this is what we did because we didn't have that much money, and it was just a spur of the moment thing, and we just was like, hey, let's just go get married. So we went to the little display ring thing and got a $10 ring for Walmart, and I still have it to this day, and I still wear it, and I'm still proud of it.
So it really is, I mean, it depends on the couple, I think, right? There's some couples where this is going to be fine. For you guys, this was really romantic. A trip to Walmart to check out rings was just as important as, like, going to some big old fancy jeweler and checking out rings there. Also, this was your romantic idea of a proposal. It's fine.
Yes, and we've been married for 8 years.
Okay. And that's the bottom line.
Get to go grocery shopping right after you get the ring. Beautiful. All in one. All
go right. To the movies.
All right, Brandy. Thanks a lot. All right. So we'll check with them on Monday and see how the whole thing went.
Listen, it's the Bert Show.